Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be learning how to scale your EpicFigRig and your Lego Minifigure inside of Blender. So the first thing you want to do is go to my other video, how to import add-ons and rig a Lego character. And once you've done that, watch that, come back to this video and the first thing you want to do is select all your accessories, or just one for now, and then select the closest part of the minifigure that it is to that accessory. So select the hair, and I'm going to select the head, and this yellow outline is the last thing you've selected, and that works for everything. So Control P now, and then Object Keep Transform, and what that does is instead of just parent object, you'll do keep transform so that it stays in that position instead of going wee, right? So yeah, so now if I move the head, it's snapped to that head. Okay, so now we're gonna scale. So select your EpicFigRig and go to object properties and go to the scale properties and unlock all these. So now what you want to do is hold down on the X axis and scroll down and you'll select all of these. Don't let go of the hold and you can scale. So I'm just going to scale them down like about there. And don't unlock these, because if you rotate with this, the torso, the legs will like spin like that. We don't want that. So what you want to do now is go to Control Tab while selecting the EpicFigRig, select the master bone and bring him down. I'm just going to add a cube so we can see what it should, like what the default size should be. So a bit smaller, I think. There we go. Control Tab. Select the master bone, bring them down. Okay, that's way too small, but that's how you scale. And in the next part, I'm gonna be showing you how to use an add-on, which scales it in a couple seconds. Okay, now what you wanna do is, this is the add-ons part, so we're gonna add an add-on, all right? So you're not going to be able to see this, I don't know why. Maybe it's like the screen recorder I use, which is just the Windows default one. So what we're going to do is go to the link in the description and download the Mecabricks Scaler for Blender, and once you've done that, it should take you to GitHub and click on code and download zip. Alright. So once you've done that, once it's downloaded, go back to Blender and click Edit, Preferences, and you won't be able to see this part. Okay, I found a way to make it work. So after you've downloaded and installed that, go to your Blender Preferences, Edit Preferences, and go to your Add-ons. Go to Install. Okay, and now what you want to do is you want to go to your downloads and you want to look up scaler, right? And then you should see this here and you just want to double click that. Okay, and now once you've double clicked on the scaler zip, it should come up like this, Mecabricks Scaler. And you just want to click the checkbox. Alright, so once you've done that, all you have to do is go out of there and select your EpicFigRig. Go to your world properties, select all EpicFigRigs, and scale down. And that's all you have to do, except for once you've scaled that down, just press Control Tab, select the master bone, and bring it down. Yep, and now I'm just going to add a default cube. Awesome. So now your minifigure is basically your default size. But when he was giant, like that, and you have a camera, and it's way too big, like your minifigure is way too big, and the camera is hard to move around, all you have to do is go to view, camera, you can go like that, you can move around, you can position it. But also, you can see like the camera is way too small. So all you have to do is press S and, selecting the leg. So select your camera and scale it up and move it. So that's an alternative way of doing it. But yes, so that is how you scale a minifigure in Blender. Hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next video.